Rainwater runoff is a huge problem in Denmark in urban areas.
In Copenhagen, we have a combined sewer system all over the city.
They rely on the water flowing in the ground or being stored.
And the runoff from rooftops, that is the runoff that we are dealing with. So if we can disconnect a significant amount of the rooftops in a city like Copenhagen, we can really take off the pressure on the existing sewer system. So the idea is to manage the stormwater runoff above ground. Water is captured in the downpipe, in a full running pipe, and then it goes below ground and up into the top of the freestanding structure. And up in the top, there's a distribution gutter that distributes the water into the central material. And that material can absorb the water, and it will then evaporate. We had come up with different types of solutions, but the understanding of these critical strength requirements, that was kind of an eye-opener.
And I just had to make a 3D drawing, import it in COMSOL to see if there's a solution and if there's another solution. Where do we have to put some extra material to withstand the wind load, heavy rainfall and snow and ice and whatsoever?
Tim Larsen, he was for sure a very important partner for the finalization and maturing of these sketches, these ideas that we had.
Then the other part came in later for the noise barrier.
He was the one also being in contact with PileByg, the other company that joined us rather late in the project.
PileByg, it is a very rare kind of business we are running. We cultivate, harvest, and process willows into sustainable products, noise barriers being one of them. And in one solution, we have solved both noise abatement and urban drainage problems.
There are a lot of things involved in a screen like this. There's wood, there's steel, and there's concrete. I imported, put the material in the right position, put on the wind load, the load from the roof as well, and also a load from the water inside the walls. Because if this is filled with water, it can be quite heavy. And then pre-stress the bolts, the main structure part of this, to take into account the bearing capacity.
Having Tim joining our team, that really helped in sizing and calculating what kind of dimensions would be needed for the pillars and for the connecting structures.
So I think it was very nice that we could use it just to show the progress for people, just like in our final report. We have a lot of Tim's drawing in the final report, but it was also something that we gave to the entrepreneurs who had to build the wall, so they knew exactly where to put the screws.
When I first saw it fully constructed, that was also really nice to see. It's a beautiful design, and the vegetation, it's developing so satisfyingly. It's not all the vegetation, but I guess 90% of what we put in there is thriving, both on the outside and on the inside of the screen.
We have this new concept in Denmark that when you have green areas, we should try to let some of the greenery just go wild. That part of the barrier I like very much. You might see that you even have weeds around the barrier. That's on purpose, and I think that's quite interesting.
I like this field of collaboration with a lot of disciplines. It can be tough and difficult because you need to try to understand what is important for the neighboring fields, your colleagues from other disciplines. But in the end, there's no way it can be done without this collaboration.